your bones next to me. And toss all your thoughts to the sea. I'll pull up each of our anchors so we can get lost, you and me. My heart is buried in Venice, hidden beneath all my worries and doubts. My heart is buried in Venice, waiting for someone to take it home. Even when you try to hide it, a smile creeps out from your face.
Ah oui, c'est bon. Vincès, mais en fait, oui, j'ai, mais ce document, il n'est pas correct.
Je vous en prie, bonne journée, madame.
Au revoir.
Au revoir, madame. Au revoir.
What?
Waiting
for someone to take it.
Take it home.
Talk about my period. I think menstrual cycles are a really cool thing to happen to like half of us in the population, and it shouldn't be stigmatized as much as it is. This is my first time using a menstrual cup for my period.
I did a bad job explaining it there, so I'm gonna re-explain it here. A menstrual cup is basically a silicone cup that you, it's about this big, that you fold and then you you sort of stuff up your vagina, and it catches your menstrual blood, and it creates like an airtight suction around inside your vaginal canal, and you can leave it in there for up to 12 hours, which is really good, because if you used pads or tampons, you can only use one for like 4 hours maybe before it starts leaking, before it reaches full capacity. Anyway, with a cup, you can leave it in for up to 12 hours. And then after 12 hours, you should take it out. So to take it out, you sort of like flatten the cup to break the suction. And then you pull it out and you dump the blood and you wash it and you put it back in. And yeah, that's the mechanisms. Oh, and I also forgot to explain the benefits. First, it's silicone, so there's no links to toxic shock syndrome compared to tampons. It has a much higher capacity than even pads, because it doesn't absorb the blood, it just catches it inside the cup. It's reusable and it's really eco-friendly, so you don't generate as much waste when you're getting rid of like disposable pads or tampons. And it's also quite versatile. I used to use pads before, and like if it gets shifted out of place, you kind of start bleeding through whatever you're sitting on. So that's really inconvenient. But for this, it just sort of sits inside you, and so it doesn't really go anywhere.
Theoretically, it shouldn't leak, although I'm still finessing the placement so that it doesn't leak, because for me, it still leaks a bit. I just woke up, I'm gonna take it out. This is day two of my period, so this should be the heaviest day.
Okay. Okay, we'll see how much it leaks this time. Be fine. You also boil your cup to sanitize it after you're done with your current cycle, so that it's clean for your next cycle. I forgot to mention that, and that's what I'm doing now. And it tasted really good, so I'm gonna try to make it again this time. Okay, so I cooked some rice from before. Here I have the carcass of leftover rotisserie chicken. There's still some meat on it, and it'll taste really good in the congee, so I'm gonna use this as well. Oh,
the sunlit days, one thing stays the same, rises the moon. Days fade into a watercolor blur. Memories swim and haunt you, but look into the lake, shimmering like smoke, rises the soon the autumn comes to darken fading summer skies. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Days pull you down just like a sinking ship. Floating is getting
the bathroom. What is that? What is that?
Do you think I can blur from this far?
I like this one.
Oh, it's actually so wholesome.
It's so wholesome.
The hair. I just want to touch it. Video called my mother, and I said that I look more and more like her physically. And she said recently a lot of people have been telling her that she looks more and more like her mother, so my grandmother. And I don't know, I think my grandmother would be really proud of the both of us. I would like to mark a milestone of my time at university so far. I got a 17.5 on a course assignment. I don't care that it was a minor assignment, it's the highest grade I've gotten here so far. Today, I will present a history of everything I wanted to do as a career. So, as with all children, I started out wanting to be an astronaut because I liked space. But then I watched a lot of movies where like astronauts get lost in space, and that really scared me. They would like get lost or they would explode. So then I was like, maybe I won't go into space, I'll work on the ground. And then I was like, oh, I can do research, right? I can be like an astrophysicist. But then I was like, oh my god, math. And then I was like, okay, maybe not as far as space. Maybe I'll study the weather, because I liked clouds. I thought clouds were really pretty, so I wanted to study the weather. But then, once again, I figured math would be involved. So I was like, I wouldn't study weather. And then it was also at that time that I developed a really big sense of social justice. I really wanted social justice to be a main part of what I do as a career. So I thought being like a weather analyst would be too niche from that goal. So I was like, I want to study the weather. And then I wanted to be a vet. But then again, math. So probably not a vet either. And also, I like animals, but again, it's not that closest social justice. So yeah, basically fields of work that weren't as related to social justice, I ruled out. So I ruled out a lot of things I wanted to be, like a potterer, an artist, an author, a musician, because I was like, they're cool, but I don't want to do that as a career. And then I wanted to be a midwife. The main reasons being, I liked the human anatomy. I liked dissecting frogs in middle school. Like, I don't get squeamish when I'm bloody things. So I was like, oh, okay, I can be a midwife. But I ruled that out because I figured you would have to study a lot of math and like physics and chemistry. So I was like, oh, okay, I won't be a midwife. And then it was, I'll be a social worker. And I actually told some friends about this before I came to university. So I was really bent on being a social worker. But then the undergraduate program that I'm in requires me to study 2 Bachelor of Arts degrees. Social work is a undergraduate program at the university I'm going to, but it's not in the Bachelor of Arts umbrella. So I can't study to be a social worker. So yeah, because of incompatibility with the program I'm in, I can't be a social worker.
So finally, I was like, maybe sociology, right?
Basically, during my time at university, I realized I really didn't like doing things that are too abstract, things that are purely abstract. So I really need to balance theoretical things with things that I can see have real world applications, immediate real world applications. So I thought sociology was a good blend of the two things.
I can't believe I forgot about journalism. So I wanted to be a journalist because those who know me know that I really like writing. So I actually applied to certain universities with an intended major of journalism. But ultimately, I went to the program that didn't have that major.
So yeah.
I'm making it embarrassing.
Identification, please. Who are you?
So here's what I know about buying medicine in France. So first you need doctor's notes and you can't print out new ones every time. I thought you could, and then I went there and they grilled me for a long time on why I have multiple copies. So that wasn't fun. Basically, use the same note for how long you're supposed to take your prescription medication. And here's what you also need, like a health care card. I'm really proud of myself for getting this card because you know how slow French bureaucracy can be. Basically, this card, you don't have to pay for the medication. The government pays for you, I guess. So yay, I can not have to pay a lot of money to buy the medication that I need to not die.